astounding waves and normal modes. Standing waves and normal modes in a string. Here I am taking a string, and in that string these waves are traveling along one direction, and after reaching the end again the wave is traveling in the opposite direction. Here then we can get the standing waves or the standing waves we will get. These are called standing waves or the stationary waves. When a wave is traveling along in the one direction, then in the opposite direction after reaching this end, again this wave comes back in the opposite direction, then we here will get the standing waves or the stationary waves. Here at the displacement is zero or the displacement is minimum, this is called a node. And where the displacement is maximum, these are called antinodes. Here the nodes and antinodes are forming in the standing waves or in the stationary waves. Here where the displacement is zero is called node, and the displacement is maximum is called antinode. For that y is equal to 2a sin kx minus omega t, where this is the 2a, this 2a is the maximum displacement, this 2a is the maximum amplitude, where this maximum amplitude is called antinode, and where the node, the displacement is zero. These are called standing waves. Here these standing waves are producing in a string, that is a here. Now by this we can write a sin kx. Already we have this sin kx is equal to 0 I am taking, where the displacement is 0, then the sin kx is equal to 0. This sin kx is equal to 0 is satisfying where the kx is equal to n pi, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Here by this we can write x is equal to n pi by k, we can write. Already we have k is equal to 2 pi by lambda. By substituting here x is equal to n pi by 2 pi by lambda, that is n, this pi pi cancel, that is a n by 2, that is a lambda n by 2. This is the x is equal to n lambda by 2, where this n is equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. This is the minimum displacement we will get, and for this minimum displacement this x is equal to n lambda by 2, that is n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on we will get. And for the maximum displacement, this for this maximum displacement we will get a sine kx is equal to 0. For the maximum displacement, this kx is equal to n plus 1 by 2 into pi, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. For the maximum displacement, this kx is equal to n plus 1 by 2 into pi. From this, k is equal to n plus 1 by 2 into pi by k. If we write this k value, we'll get this x is equal to we'll get n plus 1 by 2 into lambda by 2. Here this is the standing wave, and this is the minimum displacement and this is the maximum displacement of a wave. And in a wave, if the string has a length L, and then in the L length of the string, then n lambda by 2 we will get. That means here the string has a length, that is x is equal to 0 to x is equal to L. These are the boundary of the string. Then L is equal to n lambda by 2, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. That means 1, 2, 3 and so on. Here if we write n is equal to 1, that is l is equal to lambda by 2, we'll get lambda is equal to 2l by n we will get. Lambda is equal to, we'll get 2l by n, and where n is equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. This lambda is equal to 2l by n we will get. Here, where, for example, this we can write wavelength v is equal to, we can write n lambda, that is nu into n, okay, nu into n by 2 into l we can write, for n is equal to 1, 2, 3 we can write. For this speed v is equal to, we can write nu into n by 2l, where n is equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on, where this nu is the frequency. If n is equal to 1, then we'll get this v is equal to nu by 2l. This is called a fundamental frequency, is called a fundamental frequency of the standing wave, or this also called a first harmonic. This is called a first harmonic, where v is equal to nu by 2l is called first harmonic of the standing wave, or a fundamental frequency of the standing wave. Then in that, if we write more, that means if we write this n value 2, 3, 4 and so on, then we will get this speed of a wave v is equal to, that is n by, that is nu, 2 nu by 2l. This is the second harmonic, that is v2 I am taking, and next third harmonic 3 nu by 2l. This is the third harmonic, and v4, this is a 4 nu by 2l, fourth harmonic, and v5, this is 5 nu by 2l, fifth harmonic, and sixth harmonic, that is v6, is equal to 6 nu by 2l. If we take the ratio of this all harmonics, first harmonic, second harmonic, third harmonic and so on, then the ratio of the harmonics is equal to, we'll get 1:2, 2:3, and so on we'll get. This is the ratio of harmonics of the standing waves. Simply here, standing waves means when two waves are traveling in a stretched string, then after reaching the other end, again the wave comes in the same direction back, then we'll get the maximum and minimum displacement. Here the maximum displacement is called antinode position, and the minimum displacement is called node position. This is node, this is antinode. And sin kx is equal to 0, where the displacement is 0, then x is equal to, we'll get n pi by k, then x is equal to n lambda by 2, and where the displacement is maximum, kx is equal to n plus 1 by 2 into pi, then L is equal to n lambda by 2, where this x is equal to 0 to x is equal to L is the boundary condition for the stretching string. Then lambda is equal to 2L by n, v is equal to nu n by 2L, where this n is equal to 1, will get the fundamental frequency or the first harmonic wave. And if we write n is equal to 2, 3 and go, then we'll get a second, third, fourth harmonic like that. And the ratio of these harmonics is 1:2:3 and so on. Here, these are the standing waves and normal modes of the condition.